We live in society. We visit society. I mean, which one's more real, really? I mean, which one's really real? You know what I mean?
First, there was society, the ultimate sim environment, where players don't control virtual animated characters, but actual living, breathing human beings. They walked them, they talked them, they juiced them, they rocked them.
You can get paid to be controlled, or you can pay to control.
9 months ago, Castle unveiled a new simulation, one that would take gaming to new heights of thrilling excess and controversy.
Slayers.
If society let us live through others, Slayers would let us die through others. Slayers gives the gamer full control of a flesh and blood human being in full-scale kill or be killed combat. And when we say flesh and blood, we mean flesh and blood. Slayers. Why isn't it murder?
Gina, when's the last time you saw somebody volunteer to be murdered? I'm sure you know that every last one of our slayers is a bona fide death row inmate. Each one offered the chance to participate as an alternative to their sentence. You stay alive for 30 sessions, you get set free. That's not a bad goddamn deal.
And has any of these men or women actually survived long enough to be set free?
Well, I'd remind your audience that Slayers was put together with the full cooperation and approval of the United States federal government, that the revenue it produces is responsible for funding our entire prison system, keeping the bad guys behind bars, and that the prop was voted for by a cock-solid 68% of the American public.
In an election tainted by suspected digital fraud. Let's talk about the so-called genericons sent into the Slayers environment with a set of pre-programmed actions with no one controlling them and no way to react. Their chances of survival are next to nil.
There's plenty of men and women in prison who could never cut it as slayers. Shouldn't they be given the same chance? Roll the dice for a ticket out? Besides, they only need to survive one session.
Right. So, Mr. Castle, how the hell does it work?
It begins with a single nanocell planted in the motor cortex of the brain. This cell can replicate, replacing the cells around it with perfect copies. And these copied cells contain remote access functionality. Therefore, nano plus cortex equals a nanax.
Isn't it true that every human that undergoes this procedure will have a distinct IP address, like a mobile device or notebook computer?
Similar, but control is strictly localized to the parameters of our gaming environments. You take society, for instance. Once a cast member has left the workplace, they are completely free from the control and monitoring of their player.
Oh, well, that's a relief.
Well, to some. Maybe. To some. Don't you suspect a good many folks wouldn't mind a nitty bit of control? Someone else making all the decisions for you? No tough choices, no responsibilities.
King Castle wants you to believe that you are living in a better, safer world. He's a liar. Mind and control is slave.
Mr. Castle, we have no idea where this is.
Shush.
We will all be his dog if we allow this evolution to continue.
That's a goddamn who?
This is nuts. It's like the signal is generating simultaneously from six countries.
Bypass orbital and reroute to the backup servers, please, now.
Now!
Mr. Castle, we can't stop every virus that sneaks in.
You might want to let my boys take a look at your firewall. What about you, Sugar? Wonder if I might breach your firewall one of these days.